This is the SomaPulse P2 device. It has four settings on it. 0, 1, 2, and 3. 0 powers off the device. You can also power off the device by pulling out the battery. You can leave the battery in, but if it's going to sit for extended periods of time, more than 2 to 3 days, then I would recommend that you pull the battery out. Setting 1 turns the machine on, and it is the normal power setting. It's about 80 Gauss. There are three stimulation patterns and a rest period. There's stimulation pattern 1 for 10 minutes, stimulation pattern 2 for 10 minutes, pattern 3 for 10 minutes, and then the rest or sleep mode for about 11 and a half minutes. So the entire cycle is about 41 minutes. And then it just recycles itself, and it keeps recycling itself indefinitely until you turn it off or take out the battery. Stimulation pattern 1 will sound like a single beep. It's about 10 cycles per second, so it'll be like beep, beep, beep. Stimulation pattern 2 is more like a brrrt sound. It's a bunch of frequencies together. So when you know when it's gone into pattern 2 because the sound will change coming out of the device. Stimulation pattern 3 is the same as stimulation pattern 2, except it's in the opposite polarity. And then the rest period happens after stimulation pattern 3. You won't hear any sound out of the system, and the light will turn yellow. That runs, again, the rest period runs for about 11 and a half minutes, and then the whole system recycles itself again. It will continue to recycle until you pull the battery out or turn the power off. So this normal setting is recommended for superficial injuries or injuries that are not very deep in the body and where the coils can be placed relatively close together. In other words, there's less gap between or beside the coils. It's also for sensitive tissues that could be slightly irritated by the higher power settings, and this may also be a good setting for most animals, at least certainly to start with, because the higher intensities may make the animal a little nervous to begin with, although usually most animals like the stimulation regardless. Setting 2 is the super power setting, and so is setting 3. So setting 2 is not normal, it's higher intensity, about 130 Gauss peak intensity. It's identical to the stimulation and rest patterns that you have in setting 1, but it just has the higher magnetic field. So this setting is recommended for deeper injuries or injuries that are within thicker tissue areas where the coils must be placed relatively farther apart, like say across a shoulder or across a hip or a leg, or for tissues that are not responding to the lower power setting. Setting 3, again, is the superpower setting, about 130 Gauss, and it has an identical stimulation and rest pattern as setting 1 and 2, but without the rest period. So in other words, it runs continually, cycling back and forth between 1, 2, and 3. So it'll do 1, 2, 3, and then recycle itself again. That's not 1, 2, and 3 has nothing to do with the switches here. This is the stimulation pattern that's built into the device. And again, you'll hear the different sounds with each of these patterns. The first one, again, the first pattern, stimulation pattern, will be a single beep, 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 beep. And then patterns 2 and 3 will be brrt, 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 again, going on and off. You won't notice the difference between the polarity changes for patterns 2 and 3. It'll sound like it's just basically running continually. Once it's finished pattern 3, it recycles and starts all over again at pattern 1. During operation, regardless of the settings you have, the green light will be flashing. Okay, if the green light is not flashing, there's either no power going to it or it's not working. The only time that that's okay is when the yellow light is on continually, which usually means it's in a rest period, and that only happens with settings 1 and settings 2. Again, setting 3 runs continually. It will run continually until you either power it off, putting it down to 0, or take the battery out, or in the case that you're running the battery frequently, it may just simply, the battery may die and then the unit will stop working. Now, there are light indicators on the SomaPulse. There is a power on sequence. So you'll see the lights flashing and changing between yellow and red, and then it becomes continually green. It runs continually green, as I said, until either the battery runs out or it's finished the cycling processes with setting one, or in the case of setting three, it'll just run continually. Now, if you see the lights dim, then the battery's losing power. You may also see the lights going back and forth between green, red, and yellow. Or the light, any of the lights, will become very dim. Eventually, if you keep running it and the battery completely dies, then the unit becomes solid. There's no light at all.